Good evening, students. Today we'll start with the new topic, that is Introduction to Internet. Okay, so before we start with the topic, I want you all to revise what is internet. What do you understand with the term internet? What is network? See, network is nothing but connecting two or more computers to share the resource, share the data, and to communicate with each other. And this network is categorized into LAN, MAN, WAN, which you have learned till now. So, WAN means wide area network. One complex network connected with another complex network forms a metropolitan area network, a local area network, and wide area network. So, this combination of all this network forms a complex network that is called internet. So what is internet? Internet is a vast network that connects computers all over the world. The protocol which has been followed on internet. Now what is protocol? Protocols are rules and regulations which are followed on network. So the protocol which has been mainly followed on internet while using internet is TCP/IP. Now what is this TCP/IP? It is Transmission Control Protocol, which is used for communication standard, the way we communicate with others. Certain protocols are being followed. Okay, when we download anything, when we access anything on internet, the protocol which we follow is HTTPS, that is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So internet protocol. So there are various protocols which have been followed. So this TCP/IP protocol is the main protocol which states the communication standards. Now what is URL? URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. See, suppose I want to gift something to my friend. So what I need to do is I need to know the destination address of my friend so that I can deliver the courier over there. So what I need to put on the gift box is the address. Same way, if I want to search anything on internet, what I need to do is I need to type the address of that page on the Uniform Resource Locator, which is holding the address. URL is nothing more than the address of a given unique resource on web. Okay, so that is URL. Suppose I say www.google.com, so it is a URL. Now this URL is bifurcated into transfer protocol, domain name, directory path, and the file name. Okay, so which protocol has been followed, what is the domain, from where it has come, and the file name, that all gets included over here. Okay, now just tell me, what do you know about www? See, www stands for World Wide Web, which is commonly known as a web. What is this www? Was first developed in Geneva. Okay, so the concept over this www was to make the websites accessible throughout the world. The moment you know its URL, the moment you know the address of Google, the moment you know address of say Yahoo, you are, irrespective of your location, you are able to access that website. So that is called World Wide Web. Okay, how does it work? This www is based on several different technologies, like it requires web browser, HTML for developing the websites. It requires a protocol, HTTP. Okay, so by help of this all, this www works out. So if you are developing a website, you require a text editor, say Notepad, and HTML, where you can type the HTML language, and a web browser where you can execute the websites. And if you want to upload the website on internet, then what you require simply is HTTP protocol. Okay. Applications of this www, which all applications are applicable there of www? Applications like, by using this www, you can send emails, electronic mails, you can send chatting, you can do chatting. Okay, you can do voice chatting, voice over internet protocol. You can create your own websites. The websites can be static websites or dynamic websites. Okay. So these websites are nothing but the combination of web pages. See, suppose you open a Facebook. On Facebook, it's just one website. On that website, you have your own profile page, videos page. Okay. Then you have your information page, your friends pages, your relatives pages. So these all are what? Web pages. So these all web pages combined together forms one website. Okay. So these websites, as I said, are categorized into two, static and dynamic websites. So what is static website? A website which is standalone, which is not accepting any information. Just a visitor has to read the info. Like your online newspaper, which is not asking you to enter any data. So that all are called as static websites, which has fixed content in it. Then what is dynamic website? A website which accepts the information from the viewer and which keeps on changing based on days, which keeps on changing based on time zone, which keeps on updating. They all are called dynamic websites. Okay, the language which is used for developing the website is HTML. What is this HTML? It is just a designing part language, hypertext markup language, which is used to create the structure of the web page. Now, if you want to make the website interactive, then the language which you need to use is DHTML, that is dynamic HTML. Okay. This language is just not a markup or programming language, but it is a term that combines the features of web technology, web pages with dynamic and interactive format. Okay. Then the another language which you need to learn to make your website interactive is extendable markup language, XML, which tries to connect database with your HTML. So if you are creating if you have seen Google Form, so this Google Form is connected with Excel. MS Excel is what? A backend, a database. And your Google Form is a frontend, which you fill. So if you are giving your online exams through Google Form, your marks, your details get saved somewhere. And where does it get saved? It gets saved in Excel sheet. And your teacher gets the record. So connection of Excel with Google Form is done with the help of a language called as XML. Okay. Now this website has two concepts, that is web server and web hosting client. Now what is server and what is client? Server is a resource providing computer which is having all the resource. Now see Google, which we are seeing over here, there must be some more somewhere in the corner of a world, there must be one machine which is having all its websites, all the data. See, irrespective of your computer, if anywhere you sign into Google, you get your emails, you check the email, you sign out. Today I have checked here. Tomorrow if I will check the mails at my home, still I am going to see the same mails. So this signing in and signing off is just accessing the mails. But where these mails get permanently saved, they all get saved somewhere on the Google server. So server is having a tremendous memory storage, which is storing billions of users account over there. Okay, so this server of Google is having and running all the its websites. And what is work of web hosting? Web hosting is nothing but provides a lot of space on web server. So you are just allotting your website on a web server and you are making it accessible to all. And now what I'm doing from sitting in front of computer in a computer lab is just accessing Google. So I am, or my machine is called as web client. Okay. So web client is nothing but client machine, is nothing but a machine which is requesting for the web page. Okay. Now what is web scripting? Web scripting is a computer programming language for adding dynamic capacities to worldwide web. So if you are making, trying to make your website more dynamic, then you will use the language called as web scripting. What is web browser? We say na, we need a web browser, Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Netscape Navigator, Mozilla Firefox. Okay, then your Microsoft Edge. Which, what is this all? They all are used as a software on your computer, say on your mobile, which allows you to access the website. So web browser is the application software for accessing worldwide web. Now what is cookies? Cookies here doesn't mean the eatable cookies or the biscuits. Cookies means the temporary files which are saved on your computer. So see, if you're constantly accessing some of the pages, so every time to sign out, sign in, it becomes very difficult for a web browser to keep on sending and taking it back. So what is done? The username and password, it asks you, do you want to save your username and password permanently on this computer, permanently on this mobile? And if you click on yes, then it gets saved. So the time of the user gets saved. That is used to identify your computer as you use computer networks. Specific cookies known as HTTP cookies are used to identify specific users and which improves the web browsing experience. Now what is this plugins and add-ons? In order to customize the look and feel of the program, software makers are allowed to use plugins, add-ons, okay, so which performs the same functionality, and they are simply extensions to extend the usability of the program. So if you want to add something additional to your website, to your web page, you want to plug in, you want to get connected with some other apps, then you can use these plugins. Okay, so students, here we are done with the topic Introduction to Internet. What you are about to do is open your textbook, go through the textbook, read it properly. If you have any doubt, put the doubts on WhatsApp. Okay, your doubts will get clarified. Don't keep the doubts in your mind. Okay, have a happy weekend. Have a good day. Bye.